A very warm good morning to one and all. Here is the second video in which we are going to continue our geography chapter number 1, resource and development. In our last video, we have understood about resources and how the resources can be classified into various forms. Today, we are going to learn the types of resources in an elaborated manner. As we can see in the book, the resources can be classified on the basis of origin, that is, biotic resource and abiotic resources. Biotic resources are obtained from biosphere and have life such as human beings, flora and fauna. What are abiotic resources? Resources, those which are composed of non-living things, are known as abiotic resources. For example, rocks and metals. We can underline the definitions from the book itself. Secondly, on the basis of exhaustibility, the resources can be classified into two forms on the basis of exhaustibility. That is, renewable and non-renewable resources. Renewable resources are those resources which can be renewed or reproduced by physical, chemical or mechanical process. They are known as renewable or replenishable resources. For example, solar and water energy, forest, wildlife, etc. Now we can move forward to non-renewable resources. These resources occur in a very long geological time. These minerals and fossil fuels are the example of such resources, and they take a number of years to reform again. These are the resources which are recyclable, and some are fossil fuels which are non-recyclable. They get exhausted, or we can call finished, with their use. Thirdly, we can classify the resources on the basis of ownership. It can be divided into four forms. One is individual resource, second is community resource, third is a national resource, and fourth is international resources. Individual resources are those which are owned privately by individual. Individual means single person. Like in villages, there are people with land ownership, but there are many who are landless also. If we talk about examples, pasture lands, ponds, water in wells, etc. are some examples of resource ownership by individual. Now we move forward to the community resources. Community, that means group of people. There are resources which are accessible to all the members of the community. Means, aise resources jo log group mein use le sakte hain. For example, if I talk about villages, that is burial grounds, village ponds, etc. And if we talk about urban places, public parks, picnic spots, playgrounds, these are the places which are accessible to the people living there. Now let's talk about national resource. What are national resource? All the resources belonging to one nation is known as national resource. For example, all the minerals, water resources, forest, wildlife, land within the boundaries and oceanic areas up to 12 nautical miles, that is almost 19.2 kilometers. Yes, pura area coast ke baad ocean ka 19.2 kilometers tak hamare territorial waters mein include kiya jata hai. The resources which are found on those particular areas are known as national resources, or they belong to that particular country. Then we talk about international resources. What are international resources? The international resources are those which regulate by some international institutions. Those resources are included in exclusive economic zones, and without the permission of those international institutions, we cannot use those particular resources which are not considered in the boundary. They are open, and no nation can have an individual right on those particular resources. Now, we consider the resource on the basis of status of development. They are divided into four forms. Those are potential resource, developed resource, stock, and reserves. When we talk about potential resource are resources those who are found in a particular region, but they have not been utilized. Aise resources jo hamare region mein available hai, lekin humne unko abhi tak use nahi kiya hai. For example, if we talk about our western part of Gujarat or Rajasthan in our country, that means we have a lot of wind and solar energy. Hamare paas dhoop ki aur hawa ki koi kami nahi hai. Lekin us dhoop aur hawa ki enormous power ko पूरी तरीके से यूज करने के लिए हमारे पास अभी इतनी अच्छी टेक्नोलॉजी अवेलेबल नहीं है. वी आर यूजिंग सम पोर्शन ऑफ दैट एनर्जी बट नॉट कंप्लीटली. वी हैव अ पोटेंशियल टू यूज दैट पर्टिकुलर एनर्जी इन मोर नंबर. देन वी टॉक अबाउट डेवलप्ड रिसोर्सेज. ऐसे रिसोर्सेज जिनका सर्वे किया गया है, उनकी क्वालिटी और क्वांटिटी को डिटरमाइन किया गया है यूज़ के लिए, और हम उसकी यूज़ को टेक्नोलॉजी पे डिपेंड छोड़ते हैं. दैट मींस दोज रिसोर्सेज आर टोटली डिपेंडेंट ऑन देयर टेक्नोलॉजी एंड देयर लेवल ऑफ इकोनॉमिक फीजिबिलिटी, कि वो हमारी पॉकेट के लिए या हमारे लिए अमाउंट में कितना फीजिबल है, वो हमारे लिए ज़रूरी है. देन वी टॉक अबाउट स्टॉक. व्हाट इज अ स्टॉक? मटेरियल्स इन द एनवायरनमेंट जिनके पास ह्यूमन नीड्स को सेटिस्फाई करने का पोटेंशियल है, बट हमारे पास इतनी टेक्नोलॉजी नहीं है कि हम उसको यूज में ले सके. दैट इज व्हाई इट इज इंक्लूडेड इन स्टॉक. इफ वी आई एलैबोरेट दिस, वी नो दैट वाटर इज फॉर्म्ड फ्रॉम हाइड्रोजन एंड ऑक्सीजन, बट वी डू नॉट नो हाउ टू यूज देम फॉर दिस पर्पस. That is why it is considered as stock. Now we come forward to reserves. What is a reserve? Reserves are put into those held of existing technical know-how, but their use has not been started. That means ऐसे resources जो हमारे पास हैं, हमें पता है कि वो कैसे use होंगे, लेकिन हमारे पास उसकी टेक्नोलॉजी भी है, बट हमने उसका यूज़ अभी तक स्टार्ट नहीं किया है, क्योंकि हम उसको हमारे फ्यूचर जनरेशन की रिक्वायरमेंट्स को कंप्लीट करने के लिए रख रखा है. फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ़ आई टॉक अबाउट हाइड्रो पावर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, दैट मींस कि ऐसी रिसोर्सेज हाइड्रो पावर इलेक्ट्रिक पावर इज़ दैट which we are using in a limited extent. हम कुछ जगह उसका use में ले रहे हैं but not completely, क्योंकि हमें पता है that in future we require these resources in a more number. I hope you are clear with the types of resources. Let's move ahead to development of resource. You know that very much how important the resources are for us, and it is said that they are the free gifts of nature. And we all know कि जैसे ही human being को कुछ free में मिलता है वो उसको किस तरह से use करना start कर देता है. This is the same problem we are facing with the resources as well. There are number of problems we had started facing with the resources. Those are, resources are depleting. Resources dheere dheere karke khatam ho rahe hain. Secondly, we can say that resources have accumulated in few hands only, like rich and poor people are not able to get the benefit of the same. Thirdly, we can say that the reckless and the overuse of resources are creating environmental pollution and the land degradation. With all these things, we can say that the further use of resources should be done in a sustainable manner. In our next video, we are going to understand what is sustainable development and how the resource planning can be done for the further distribution. Till then, stay safe, stay home. Thank you.